My name is Chirag Desai, and I'm Associate Professor of Surgery, and I'm currently a Director of a Chronic Pancreatitis and Autologous islet cell Transplant Program, and a Surgical Director of a Liver Transplant Program here at University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill. I come from India, and the place where I come had like lots of doctors, and my sister was my first doctor in my whole family, in extended family and everyone, and she has been my hero in my whole life. So she inspired me and I wanted to be a doctor after her. When I started my medical school and started dissecting the cadavers for my anatomy lessons, from that side I wanted to do something with my hands and be in the medicine field, and nothing other than surgery matches my goal at that time, and that's why I thought I'll be a surgeon. So my specialty is mainly a liver transplant. Though I do some kidney transplants, and I'm very well trained in intestinal transplant as well. And apart from that, I do very complex liver and the pancreatic surgeries, mainly for a benign pancreatic disorders like a chronic pancreatitis, recurrent pancreatitis, where we take out the whole pancreas and I digest the cells, which are exocrine cells, and only keep the endocrine islet cells, and we infuse back into the liver, and that's what is called autologous islet cell transplant. Usually, one third of the patient don't require any insulin after this surgery. One third of them, they require a small amount of the insulin, but the sugar controls are much better. Whereas the one third of the patient might require more amount of insulin because the pancreas was so damaged, so we just retrieve minimal amount of the cells. But still they have advantage because their low blood sugars will not be so low. It is so unique because it requires a specialized GMP facility, good manufacturing practice facility, where you take these organs, you digest them, and you take out only the 1% of the cells from this whole organ, which is going to give insulin to this patient, and you give it back to this patient. So first of all, these diseases are very difficult. Their abdomen have lots of complexity, so surgeries are difficult. And after the surgery, they're getting cells are difficult, and putting them and then taking care of this patient, everything together, this whole, a program, a whole therapy, is such a complex and requires so attention to detail at multiple different stages, and that's why it is very unique and rare, and not many people do it. UNC is a good historic university, and the students and the resident who comes, they come from a very good background. So I see it as a great opportunity for everything, for treating patients, educating students and residents, as well as for research and good support about that. In all my career between India and in America, I've been trained by very good surgeons, you know. And when you get trained well, it's like any sports. You have a great coach, and if your player is good, he can take it to the next level. And I see myself here when I'm mentoring the residents. These are good players which can take it to the next level if they get all the attention to the details can be taught to them. So I feel very good operating with the residents in the OR and teaching them very small details which I learned over a period of last 21 years of surgery which I have been doing. I do like education, I do academics, I write papers, I go to the conference. Recently I was invited in China to give a lectures on a chronic pancreatitis and autologous islet cell transplant, which I feel for me is a great level of satisfaction that okay, you know, I'm doing something, somebody's recognizing. But nothing compares to when my patient, they walk off the hospital after they get better and they come back to see me in the clinic and I get a warm hug from them. That is the most gratifying thing compared to any other aspect of the job I do actually.